Hi guys, today I'm gonna talk about lenses. And in this video I'm just gonna quickly go through all the lenses that I own at the moment. So if you don't really like the idea of listening to me talking about lenses for 10 minutes, just press the back button in your browser and watch something else and wait for my next video, which will be a more normal one. So, I spent a lot of time researching and purchasing and buying and selling lenses, and it's actually like, for me, photography, the fun in photography is 50% actually being out and taking photos, and it's 50% trying to find the best lenses out there. I really like researching lenses a lot, and I spend a lot of time doing it. And also I tend to update my collection of lenses a lot. Usually I only own like 6 or 7 lenses at a time, and then when I'm getting tired of a lens, or rather I find another lens that is even more interesting to me, I sell a lens and then I use the money to buy another one. And nowadays I tend to mostly buy used lenses, so that means that I almost always get my money back when I sell a lens. So basically I'm renting lenses for free, which is a great concept. So, enough of that, let's go through my current collection of lenses that I currently own. So let's begin with this one. This is actually my latest purchase. I only owned it for a couple of weeks, and actually I've hardly used it so far. I will probably do a video about it very soon. But what it is a Voigtlander 20mm f3.5. So it's a very wide angle lens, but not like super fast, but it's very compact and small and lightweight, as you can see. It's for Canon mount, but I think they make them for Nikon as well, and possibly other systems. And the reason I bought this lens is I really love the focal length. I love the 20mm focal length because it is very wide angle, so you can easily take in a whole landscape. But it is not so wide angle so that the images start looking weird. As you might have seen in, for example, 15mm or 16mm lenses, in a lot of angles the images don't really look natural, they look like stretched and weird. But with 20mm, at least if you ask me, that is about as wide as you can go without images looking weird. So I love this focal length. And earlier I owned a Sigma 20mm f1.4, which is obviously a lot faster than this one and optically better. But the Sigma was so big and heavy, so that it was kind of a pain to carry it around, especially to travel with it. It was not really that much fun, even though the images came out really, really nice. So later I bought a Voigtlander 21mm f1.8, which was also a great lens. It is a lot smaller and lighter than the Sigma, but it is a manual lens, but I mean at this focal length, I usually want to use manual focus anyway, and it's quite easy to get like most of the stuff in front of you in focus anyway at this wide angle. But anyways, I sold that lens to buy my action camera, the Sony X3000, so that I could record these videos. And now I thought, I want a 20mm again, so I bought this one because it was very cheap. I bought it used for 2000 Swedish kronor, which is, what is it, like $250 maybe. And so I think it's great value for money. It is, it has pretty good optics. It's not like perfect optically, but it is, according to me, good enough. And I will spend some time very soon testing it out more in detail, and I will report back to you guys. So that is a tip for a small pancake-ish 20mm lens. Then we have another Voigtlander, one of my favorite lenses, and one that I think I will keep for a long time probably without selling it. It's the Voigtlander 35mm f1.7 Ultron for Leica M. So I'm using an adapter to use it on my Sony A7, and it's, as you can see, a manual focus lens. But it is really, really nice, and as you can see, extremely small and lightweight considering that it is a 35mm f1.7, which is pretty fast. Earlier, I mean, I really liked the 35mm focal length, and earlier I owned the Sigma 35mm f1.4 Art, which is almost perfect optically, as most of the Sigma Art lenses are. And I really loved that lens, and it took really, really nice images, and it is of course a little bit faster, but the lens was so big and heavy, again with the Sigmas, it was so big and heavy so that it took a little bit of the fun out of using that lens. And I found this Voigtlander, which is almost on the same level optically, but so much smaller, so much lighter, and of course it doesn't have autofocus, but then again, if you're not like photographing sports or small children running around all the time, I don't really think you need autofocus. And in a lot of ways it's nice with a proper manual focus lens that is used, that is supposed to be used for manual focus, because then you have this really nice feeling of control whenever you take a photo, so you can never be fooled in any way, because you are in total control of where the focus is, and that is a nice feeling in many ways. So I can really recommend that lens. I think it cost me around 5,000 Swedish kronor, which is maybe $600, and I bought it used but in mint condition, and I think it's good value for money. I mean, it's about the same price point as you would find a new Sigma 35mm Art for. Another thing that I didn't mention with this lens is that it has a lot nicer bokeh than the other 35mm lenses out there, if you ask me. There is something about the bokeh that you only see this thing in like some Leica lenses. It is like really, really creamy and smooth in a way that you cannot really see in the Canon or the Sigma lenses. Have a look at some of the sample shots I'm showing now, and hopefully you understand what I mean. It's something special about the bokeh that I really, really like. Really nice bokeh. This is a really nice 55mm. You could call it the Nifty 50 of the 70s. It's the Minolta MC Rockor 55mm f1.7. And actually the lens itself is a lot smaller than this, because I have an adapter here that I can take off. And then I also have a hood and a filter that I can also take off. I actually did another video especially about this lens, so if you're interested you can check that out. As you can see, it's very, very small, and what you can't see is that it's also very, very lightweight. And it has a good quality feel to it, and it is bright, and it has really nice bokeh. And I really love this lens. And what I haven't told you yet is also that it is extremely cheap. I bought it for 400 Swedish kronor, used of course, which is, what is it, $50 maybe, 55. And this lens is very sharp, and it's great, great value for money. If you want like the best value for money, the cheapest possible 50-ish millimeter lens, and you don't care about autofocus, this one is really, really great. But if you do care about autofocus and you need a very, very cheap but still good 50mm lens, I would recommend the Nifty 50 from Canon, which currently sits on my 400D. And this is a lens that of course most of you guys probably know about, but I still want to mention it because it is such a great value for money. Very sharp at most apertures, not like perfectly sharp wide open, but almost. And very cheap, very lightweight, very small, fast autofocus. Yeah, I like it a lot. The Canon 50mm f1.8 STM. Then we have macro. As you all know, I'm really into macro photography. I really love macro photography. And my current weapon of choice is this Tamron 90mm f2.8. It's a pretty regular macro lens, but the reason I bought it is because it is great value for money. This lens comes in many different versions because they've done updates a lot of times. And this version is good because it is only, I bought it for 4,000 Swedish kronor, which is around $500. And it's great because it has image stabilization, it is very lightweight and easy to carry around. Earlier I had the Sigma 150mm f2.8, which is a super great lens, but it is a little bit too heavy for me. I didn't really enjoy carrying it around because it was so heavy. So with this lens I get almost the same level of image quality, or I mean the same level of image quality I get, but the images are not quite as nice with the shorter focal length, but still very nice. And so I really like this lens. If you want a great value for money macro lens, I can recommend the Tamron 90mm f2.8. Then, for portraits, I currently have the Samyang 135mm f2. And very recently I did a complete video about the 135mm f2 lenses, the whole family of lenses that comes from different brands, and how much I love them because of their extreme sharpness, very nice bokeh, extremely good blurriness of background if you're into that kind of thing. And these are so great for portraits, and they are not like too big and heavy considering their optical performance, so I really like them. And actually this one, the only drawback with the Samyang is that it is manual focus, and in some cases when you're doing portraits that is a bit of an issue, because if you're trying to photograph someone who is moving or walking towards you or something like that, it is a bit of a struggle to get the manual focus in the right place. You miss a lot of shots. So I'm actually planning to sell this one and get the equivalent Canon version, the 135 f2 Canon lens. It is a bit more expensive, but it has autofocus, and the image quality or the optical performance is almost on the same level as the Samyang. I guess the difference is that this Canon has a little bit of chromatic aberration, but it's like very, very little, almost not noticeable, and I would take the autofocus instead of like super duper extreme perfect image quality. Oh, last but not least, we have another great value for money lens, now attached to my super macro rig that I did another video on. But the white thing here, the Canon 40mm f2.8, also a super great lens. It's, as you can see, a pancake lens, very, very small and compact. Super sharp on all apertures, quite cheap. I don't remember what it cost me, but it wasn't that much. I ordered it on eBay from Korea and it was super cheap, even though I bought it new. So I can recommend, in general, look on eBay to find some Canon lenses very cheaply. Could be a good option. So, that's it for this video. A quick recap of all the lenses I currently own. It is the end of January 2018. And I will check back in a couple of months or so when I've updated my collection, probably with a lot of other lenses, maybe. So these are my full frame lenses. I also started to get into the Micro Four Thirds system. I'm actually filming this on a Panasonic G80, but I'll talk about those lenses in another video. And in a later video, I also plan on talking about my favorite lenses of all time that I don't own any longer because I sold them. I have a lot of lenses that I would actually like to buy back because I love them so much. Anyways, that's a later video. Please give your comments or thumbs ups, or maybe even thumbs down, I hope not, about this video and this new format where I talk about a subject. I hope it was entertaining, I hope I didn't bore you too much. Please comment what you thought about it and I will try to take in your feedback and adjust accordingly. Please subscribe if you liked this video and want to see more of my photography videos. See you soon again, over and out.